Welcome to Wake Up to Health Talks. With this brand new initiative, we are on a mission to raise awareness about the latest, about the most prevalent healthcare challenges spread across the country. And on this journey, we are joined by the leading medical practitioners across the country who are going to talk to us about these healthcare challenges and help us understand a little bit more about these healthcare challenges. For our first episode, we are going to talk about one of the leading healthcare challenges this country is facing, especially during the COVID-19 scenario, that is mental health and mental wellness. And I'm extremely excited to invite Dr. Samyak Tiwari, a leading psychiatrist from Lucknow, to shed some light on this. Welcome, Dr. Tiwari.
Thank you so much, Apurva, and it's a pleasure to be a part of this amazing initiative by Cadila Pharmaceuticals. I must really appreciate Cadila and its employees for conducting such an innovative, productive webinar kind of a program, where this is an initiative, I think, to actually make people, the common people, aware, make of them aware about the problems which we all are facing these days. Because most of the webinars which are happening these days are more of academic webinars. And it may be useful, for the academicians, but something of this sort thought by Cadila to actually help the common man is something appreciable.
Exactly, sir. That is what we're trying to achieve here. And sir, before we begin, yeah. I have a interesting story to share with you and with all of our viewers. So, I was in conversation with a friend of mine yesterday night, and she's currently working in Mumbai while her home is in Chennai. And I asked her about Diwali plans. And she revealed to me that she's not traveling anywhere. I mean, it was heartbreaking to hear that she's not going home on Diwali. Because
I can understand.
With joy and celebrations and family. And I'm sure she's not the only one. We are all coping with this pandemic and we're all trying to celebrate this Diwali, celebrate this festival season the new normal way. So, sir, do you have precautions? Do you have any things that we should remember while we go on in this festival season?
See, Apurva, definitely it would have been so nice for all of us who are especially away from our parents and close ones to be with them and celebrate this this amazing festival of Deepavali.
Exactly.
But unfortunately, this COVID-19 has restricted us, and it's always better to, at least these days, avoid traveling. And somehow, if you can manage traveling by road, then it's definitely okay. But safety first, and many such more Deepavalis are yet to come. So we should first protect ourselves, and then we should venture on these adventures. But obviously I would say that it would have been much better for all of us, especially for those ones who are unable to get close to their family members, to be there and enjoy this festival.
Sure, absolutely. But as you very well said, that there are many more Diwalis to come. We should look at the bigger picture rather than just focusing on
definitely.
So, sir, this pandemic has been actually very tiring and very cumbersome for all of us. And, you know, kids are learning at home. They're not going to schools. Young professionals are working from home. The elderly, they're especially lonelier than ever. So, can you shed some light on this? I'm sure this must have a major impact on our mental health and mental wellness.
Oh, yes, definitely. See, human beings are emotional beings and social beings. So we obviously like to be together. And this COVID-19 has brought all of us towards a new kind of a lifestyle. And this lifestyle is not being actually appreciated by most of us. But safety first, as I have already told. Definitely, we are missing our old times. But I hope and I wish that these bad times will soon get over, when we'll enjoy the same parties and same school and same cinema. So, but yes, you are absolutely right. It is really causing a lot of stress on all of us, because we have been trained, we have been living with this kind of a social lifestyle all our life, right from the early childhood. And so it's a sudden change, which is not appreciated by any one of us. So pray to God that this time goes off as soon as possible.
Absolutely, sir. And sir, as you said that this current lifestyle, so our lifestyle has taken a hit. We are not moving around as we want to. And let's face it, how much we want to do yoga at home, we're still not able to achieve that lifestyle that we led before. So this lifestyle, this doing physical exercise, does that have an effect on our mental wellness?
See, obviously, it has been very well documented that any kind of physical activity, be it the outdoor or indoor, it releases certain neurohormones, especially dopamine and serotonin, which lead to an emotional and mental well-being. And we feel more enthusiastic and we feel more lively. So definitely we are missing out those things. And I seriously feel that this kind of a lifestyle which we are living right now cannot go for a long time. See, initially when the lockdown was on, we heard a very fashionable kind of a statement, the new normal. The new normal. But this is new something, I would say that this is new abnormal. Something abnormal which is nearly really new to us.
Absolutely.
So at that time, see, we were all so much bothered and even more so painful and miserable with such a not exactly a lockdown, but a house arrest, I would say. So it was necessary for each one of us to encourage. And so we were using these kind of terms like new normal. But actually now speaking truly is something is new abnormal. So it cannot go for a long time. It has to get over.
And we are praying for that. We are looking at all the pharmaceutical companies to come up with a vaccine and end this.
Definitely.
Absolutely, definitely. Sir. And sir, as you said that we're all sticking together and it's very important for us to, as you said, that we brought this term of new normal just to support each other. So sir, can you
give
some tips and can you share some ideas how we can cope with this? And if suppose I'm talking to my friend again and she tells me that she's feeling sad and she's feeling lonely, what are the things I can tell her so that, you know, she can at least feel a little bit better and can help her in some way?
See, obviously, as I already told, that physical intimacy, being physical together, having that kind of a social gathering, that is irreplaceable.
Absolutely.
So if, now comparatively, the fear factor for COVID has gone down. For what reason? I exactly don't know. But people are not as apprehensive as they were a few months back.
Absolutely.
So now with proper precautions, you wearing a proper mask, which is being not worn or not being worn for a number of days. It's being changed, say, regularly after 2 to 3 days. Wearing proper mask, maintaining a social distance. You can go out, hang out with your friends, have a cup of coffee, try to change that routine, that monotonous routine which you were following for so many months. Then if you are not very much enthusiastic going out, you're reluctant, then you can, what I feel that this pandemic, as I've already many times I have spoken in my seminars that adversity helps in advancement. So this adversity has definitely forced us to look the life in a different way. For example, as I tell you about myself,
sure.
I've always been a or outdoor kind of an individual right from my young school days, and so I was not very techno savvy. But this COVID-19 has forced me to become a better, at least better on gadgets as I was four or 5 months back. So this is actually giving you an opportunity to transform yourself from, say, position where you were not so much skillful in anything which you like to be, to a better form. And I have advised conducted many such webinars. So what I emphasized upon was that children and even young people, they should try to when this COVID-19 gets over, your transformed form should come out. If you are obese, you should reduce weight. If you are unable to speak a proper language, any language, you should work on that language, because communication skills is extremely important.
Absolutely.
If you feel that you need to work upon any of your subjects, suppose for young children, especially, I can relate to that, as I was an extremely poor student of mathematics. So people who have been, people who feel that they have certain kind of shortcomings in any subject, they can have more time to do on that, because now we are not traveling. When we were going to school or office or any organization, especially in big cities like Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata, you have to expend almost 4 to 5 hours every day to travel.
Absolutely.
Now that time is being saved. So you can utilize that time in your personal development. You can become a better version of yourself. This is what I emphasize. So this is how you can actually take the advantage of this adversity.
That's a great thought, to focus on the positivity and focus on developing new skills and new hobbies. I think that's the best way to come out of this pandemic. This has been quite insightful, and this has been quite helpful. And I'm sure my friends and my viewers, they would have understood a little bit about mental wellness and how can they cope better during this COVID-19 scenario.
Definitely.
And sir, before we close, do you have any message for the viewers or something that you want to impart?
See, apart from being a psychiatrist, I am a professional. I would say a professional because I take up this endeavor and job of mine extremely seriously. I work for it for 2 to 3 hours every day. So I'm a motivational speaker, and I go to various schools and colleges to motivate people. Mm-hmm. And what I've seen with almost, say, majority of students and people who are heading towards making their career, they don't have a vision in their life. If you ask anybody, anybody in the school who's about to leave the school, say, person who is in class 11th or 12th, or person who is just about to complete his graduation, if you ask them what you exactly want to do in life, they have no idea. I called it bum car mentality. Bump car mentality.
Okay.
You must have gone to those amusement parks where there are bump cars.
Yeah, the bumping cars, yes.
And you don't have a control over it. Somebody comes from behind and hits you. Somebody comes from the side, he hits you. And you really don't have any control. You are going out of the... You are on a autopilot mode. You don't have any control over it.
Yes.
So we, most of the individuals, we are living in a bump car mentality. And I often use this term. So please get out of this bump car mentality and have a definite vision, which is a vision of your own. And the vision should be only one. It should not be many visions. And then work on it. Work on it. Otherwise, you will be doing something which you don't like. And that would be a miserable life.
Sure, absolutely. So I think the best way to move forward is to, focus on something productive rather than just thinking negative thoughts and investing in yourself.
Definitely, definitely. It is very important for people to invest in yourself. And the best way to improve yourself is identify your shortcomings, write those shortcomings on a piece of paper, and then work on each one of them, so that you become a transformed individual on your way ahead towards your life.
Absolutely. This will also help us be aware of the shortcomings that we have. That's a great tip. I think I'm going to try that out myself.
Definitely. All of us, in fact.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much for your time, and thank you for joining us. I'm sure this has been helpful.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And before we have, yes. Go ahead.
Please, sir. No, continue.
I just want to say that this is an amazing initiative, and this would definitely help people at large. And I really appreciate once again Cadila and especially Apurva, you and your team, to conduct such kind of productive, innovative programs. And I think that this would really add value to the life of people, of especially Ahmedabad and Gujarat.
Absolutely, sir. We want to achieve that with this initiative. Thank you so much, sir. And thank you, viewers.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure.
Come back again with the brand new initiative, brand new episode of Wake Up to Health. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.